Does that highlight on fleek? Let me know. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I am going to be sharing with you my June favorites. I love these videos, as I always say, because I just love sharing what my favorites were for the past month. I literally cannot believe that we're already in July. It's summertime, it's hot in New York. Yes, I am ready to get lit. I hope you guys are too. I don't have that many favorites for this month. I feel like I always say that. Well, I have quite a few. So if you guys are interested in knowing what my favorites were for the month of June, then just stay tuned. I'll see you in the video. Bye guys. Okay, sorry for the not so cute background today. The lighting is being a little cray cray, and like I said before, I film with the natural light, so we're just gonna have to work with it. We're just gonna have to. Okay, so let's just jump into the favorites. The first product that I'm going to talk about is actually a highlight. I think I have like two highlights to talk about. First one that I'm going to talk about is my Urban Decay Afterglow Highlight in the shade Sin, of course. I definitely had to talk about this highlighter because I've literally been rocking it like all month long, and I'm pretty sure I'm going to be rocking it like all summer long, or like forever really, because it's not like it's a limited edition product. What I love about this highlight is how creamy it is and how like champagne and golden it is. I recently went away and I got tanned, as you can see, I'm sure, and wearing this just like makes it 10 times better because I just feel like it is so like bam in your face. Like, check out that highlight bling. It is just like so freaking good. So I'm gonna swatch it for you guys, even though I'm sure you guys already know what it looks like. Okay, so this is what the highlight looks like. It is so freaking beautiful. And yes, it is just like popping. I purchased mine at, I think it was Sephora. So you can get it at Sephora or Ulta, you know. I always gotta talk about a highlight and my favorites, per usual. All right, so the next... Oh my gosh, I almost dropped it. So the next highlight that I am going to be talking about is one from Josie Maran. It's actually a cream highlight, and I literally wore this every day on vacation. When I do like no makeup makeup looks, I also like to wear this. So like on a daily basis, I pretty much do no makeup makeup looks, because it's just like too much to put a full face of makeup on every day. Like, let's just be real with each other, right? Like, we're all friends here. I'm not really trying to put makeup on every single day. So I will add a little bit of this to the tops of my cheekbones, and it just looks stunning. So I'm gonna do a little swatch, and I'm also gonna show you guys, this is what the packaging looks like. It's like a beautiful gold packaging, and then it kind of just, it's just a cream stick highlight. It's called the Josie Maran Argan Enlightenment Illuminizing Wand. It's so good. It kind of reminds me of the Benefit What's Up highlighter, which I also kind of want to get. I have a small sample size that I'm still working with, but literally love this thing. Like, I will probably be repurchasing this forever because it just looks so good and so natural on the skin. And even if you're not going for a no makeup makeup and you just want to like put this on and then layer another highlight on top, that will look freaking phenomenal, girl, I promise you. So let me just show you a swatch. So this is the Josie Maran highlight right here. So you kind of see in comparison to the Urban Decay Sin. It's for sure a lot more subtle. Definitely a lot more golden, I would say. But it is still so freaking stunning. Ugh, I love it. Also just wanted to show you a close-up of what the actual like packaging looks like too. So there you have it. So the next face product, well, I have a lot of face, okay, they're all like face products, but whatever. The next thing I'm going to talk about is actually my Makeup Forever Contour Kit. This is in the shade 40, and I literally love this. It is so creamy, so buttery, and just like so amazing. Like, this is what it looks like. So kind of just... It is so freaking beautiful, like literally. Okay, so I purchased this a while back. I'm pretty sure you guys probably remember it if you do like keep up with my videos and stuff. It was a part of a Sephora haul. I think it was like, oh, either a random Sephora haul or the VIP haul, whatever. That doesn't even matter. But it was a part of a Sephora haul, and I purchased this. It was a shade, like, I thought it was a shade darker because I wasn't really that tan before. This works phenomenal. You guys are gonna be seeing a video pretty soon with me using this, and I am like literally obsessed with it. Like, so obsessed. It's so creamy. Like, I don't want to say it's better than the Anastasia one, but it is. And yeah, I just feel like it's so worth the money, so worth the price. I feel like it was like $45 or $40 to $45, and it was just so good. Like, they're so buttery. Like, I don't even need to use a freaking oil, and to me that is amazing. Like, oh my god, it's like a highlight but not a highlight. I mean, I did apply it to the tops of my cheekbones, not today, but I have tried it and it's okay. It's kind of just like a layering factor. I'll show you guys what it looks like. So I swatched the contour color and the highlight. So this is actually the contour color in that Makeup Forever contour kit. And then this is the highlight. So it kind of just gives a little bit of a sheen. It's okay. I'm not that obsessed with it. To me, the most important thing is the contour color. And it's just beautiful. To me, it's just beautiful. And the creaminess and like blendability of the product, that's what I'm most concerned about. Because I don't want to like use something that's going to take me a million years to use. Like the Anastasia contour kit, not that it took me a million years to use, but it was just like so many steps to make it work for me. I mean, don't get me wrong, I still use that shit because it was, I mean, $40 or whatever, so I'm still trying to get my money's worth, like, you know how makeup junkies are. I purchase makeup, I want to use it up, so that's what I'm going to do. No hard feelings against that kit, but I definitely do love the Makeup Forever Pro Contour Kit also. So the next thing that I'm going to talk about is actually a foundation that I've been wearing ever since I got a little bit more tan. I was able to whip out this foundation again. So this is the Buxom Show Some Skin Foundation. I am in the shade Caramel Kisses since I'm tan. And guys, let me tell you, I am obsessed with this foundation. I actually have it in two shades. So like when I'm not tan, I have another one. I think it's called Almond the Nude. But since I am tan, I'm using Caramel Kisses. And it is so like amazing. I can use this foundation for every single day and I just know it won't fail me. It blends out so good with a brush or a beauty blender. It is just like bomb.com. It's a reasonable price. I think it's like $38 or something like that, and I feel like that's pretty reasonable for foundations, especially like YSL and, you know, Giorgio Armani. Those are like $60 foundations, so this is definitely a really, really good one. And also, since it's summertime, I don't like wearing super heavy foundations, so being that this is like Show Some Skin, it's literally like Show Some Skin, like it lets your skin shine through. And it's actually the foundation that I'm wearing today, and can I just tell you, I love the finish. Like, let me know guys in the comments what you think of the finish of the foundation, but I am totally like loving it, boo. Hell yeah. So again, that is the Buxom Show Some Skin Weightless Foundation. Total fave. So the next thing that I'm going to be talking about is actually a blush palette. I showed this in my MAC haul. I have literally been obsessing over these blushes, guys. Like, this is the only palette that I've been touching, and that is why I purchased this, because I was like, I know I'm gonna use this all the time. Like, not only is it gonna be a summer staple, but just an all year round staple, and the shades that I picked are just like so bomb.com that I'm just like, oh my god, did I pick those? Ah. So this is the palette. Let me give you guys a close-up. I actually have a mixture of these two. I have Eternal Sun mixed with Peach Twist, and that kind of gave me like this like bronzy-ish, like corally kind of, I don't even know if you guys can really tell, cheek, which I am literally obsessing over for summertime. And that's why I was like, I'm definitely getting this palette, because I know damn well that I'm gonna be using it every single day. And like I said, I'm gonna be using it. I'm going on a cruise soon, and I am definitely taking this baby with me, holding it close to my heart for real. So again, that is my MAC blush palette, and this is actually a new size in the little pro palettes that they make. So if you guys want to know more about this palette and everything, I'll link my MAC haul down below, because I explained a little bit more in detail. Since this is a favorites video, I don't want to go off on a tangent and bore you guys with a ton of other information that you don't need or might need, so I'll link the video down below. Two tools that I'm going to be talking about are brushes. So my first favorite brush for the month of June is my MAC 224. I literally always use my Sigma E40, and I just was like, okay, I just want to use something different for once and just try something else out. My MAC 224 has literally become the only brush I use. Like, I will use this for my whole freaking eye makeup look. So of course it's really good for laying down that first transition color, but I mean, even if you want to deepen it up, it's just like the taperedness of it is just so good that my Sigma E40 is almost like too big now. And I don't know if it's because I've had it for a while or because I've been washing it or what, but everyone always says that these are dupes for each other, and I don't really agree. That's just my opinion. I feel like the Morphe M441 is more of a dupe in my opinion for this. Just because of the domed like shape of the brush. I don't know. It's just so freaking good and it just gets in there precisely. And I don't know if it's because it's not like I have huge eyes. So that could be another reason why I love this so much. But literally guys, this is my fave. So let me just show you guys a close up. So here is a close up of the 224. And you can just see, like, it's a little bit more dome-shaped, not so humongous, and it's just perfect. So, again, that is my MAC 224. Oh, and the only crappy thing, it's kind of pricey. Sorry, guys. I know, I hate it, too. I really want to buy another one, and I'm like, ugh, do I have to? But I might just have to. So, the next brush that I'm going to be talking about, which is... I don't know what's the deal with Morphe right now, but I think it's discontinued or they might be making a new version of it. But the brush that I wanted to talk to you guys about is my Morphe E4 brush. This has become my favorite blush brush. When I first got it, I always used it every day. And then I kind of like forgot about it because I got more brushes and I just started using the other brushes. No hard feelings, but you know, sometimes you want to try out some new things. No big deal. So I'm back on the E4 bandwagon and it is just so perfect. Like you see guys, it just fits so good on my cheek and just like so good. I don't know, like yes, I just love it. Like what do you think? So I don't know, I think it's because it's like angled that is why I love it so much. But then again, I have a Sigma brush that's angled that I don't love too much. I just think it's this brush, like the bristles are so soft. When I wash it, it still stays in place. Like Morphe brushes just have my heart, guys, like literally. But they had like 60% off of these brushes and I bought like 3 E4s because I was so nervous. I was like, oh my God, what if like this brush never comes back and like I need it for the rest of my life? Like, what am I gonna do? Oh my God. So I bought like 3 of them. So yeah, again, that is the Morphe E4. Yes, boo. Let me just show you guys a close-up. So here is a close-up of the E4. It is just so perfect. Ugh. There's a little bit of blush on it right now. It's kind of dirty. Used it today. Please don't mind. Hey guys, we are nearing the end. So the next product that I'm going to talk about is actually a hair product. This is the Ouai Hair Oil. So Ouai is a brand that was, you know, made up by the celebrity hairstylist Jen Adkin. She is the Kardashians hairstylist. And this is actually the only product that I bought from the hairline. And I have just, like... obsessed, in love, like I don't even know what, but this is like a holy grail product for me. It has been my tried and true favorite. I don't know why I didn't like mention it in my last month's favorites, but I had to mention it now because it is just so good. So it is the hair oil and I don't know what I do typically is I will get out the shower, freshly washed hair, put some pumps of hair oil on, and let's not forget the scent is like so amazing. I saw some reviews on Sephora and I was like, what are these people talking about? Because it smells so good. Like I love this scent. That's just my opinion, but you know, it's kind of like florally and fresh. So it definitely adds like to making your hair smell even better after washing it. That's what I was saying. Get out the shower, brush through my hair, put some hair oil in it, kind of just like mess up my hair a little bit, make sure I can work it in, and then brush it again, work it in some more, let my hair air dry. My hair air dries so freaking good now. Either that or I'll put a little mousse, like today's little wavy hair thing that I got going on, it's pretty much the hair oil, a little bit of mousse. I'll put my hair up in like fun buns like overnight and sleep like that, and I wake up and my hair looks like this. I should also mention this hairstyle. Like, I'm loving this hairstyle for summer. What do you guys think? Do you like it? Do you think I should just, like, leave my hair straight? I don't know. I'm trying not to put heat on it, so that's why my hair is like this. So, yes, love this hair oil. It definitely helps with making my hair look, like, nice and wavy and stuff. And, yeah, it's just so good. It's kind of pricey for an oil, but, guys, it is worth it. Another oil that I'm definitely trying to get pretty soon is the Living Proof one. I think it's like No Frizz something. What Would Lizzie Do mentioned it in one of her videos, and my sister is like swearing by it recently. So I think I'm gonna have to try that one out too. See, everyone is just influencing all of my purchases. My gosh, how much money am I gonna be spending? Damn, homegirl needs like 10 jobs. What's up? The next product that I am going to be talking about, we are almost there. We are almost there. Oh, it is actually a toner water from Lush. This is the Roma toner water from Lush. If you guys watch my current skincare favorites, I was talking about the tea tree toner. So of course I still have my tea tree toner, that's my tried and true, but when I went to Lush, I kind of wanted to try another water, and I ended up picking up this one. I picked up the smaller size just in case I wasn't loving it, but I am, which is why it's in my favorites. It smells so good. It kind of has like this rose, like lavender scent, which I'm pretty sure that's what it says. Gentle rose and lavender tonic for everyday use that helps hydrate sensitive or mature skin without causing it to overreact. It is such like a beautiful smelling water. Does that make sense? Love putting it on my face, like morning, just before I put my makeup on, I'll put this on. Just a refresher is really what I use it for. It is so good. And you know what else? Another thing that I do, I'll put it in the refrigerator and then like I'll take it out, spritz a little bit on myself, and it makes your skin feel so good. Like that little burst of like coldness just adds to like the whole thing. It adds to the smell, it adds to like feeling like a spa. It's just like, damn, I got a spa in my house, girl. I don't even need to spend the money on a spa. Right? So again, that is the Lush Roma Toner Water. And I'll give you guys a close-up too. Action. So now this is the last product that I'm going to be talking about. And like I had mentioned in one of my last favorite, in the last favorites video that I had filmed, I kind of wanted to just share with you guys the scent that I've been wearing for the month. So for this past month, I have been rocking YSL Black Opium. Right now I'm using my little travel size one since I went away and everything. I wanted to just like continue using it. It's good to have in my bag and everything. But this is what the bottle looks like. It's mini, has a little cap, and it's actually like a pump, so it's not like a roller ball. I actually like these little spritzers because I feel like I'm getting more out of it. But yeah, I'm obsessed with this scent, guys. That's all I could say. It smells so good. It's very sweet, and I don't even know if it's really like a summery scent, but I'm obsessed with it. And I don't even care about like, oh, I wear this scent in the summer and I wear this scent in the winter. Like, I wear whatever scent I want, whenever season I want. So let's just get that out the way. Kind of pricey. I haven't started using, I actually bought like a gift set that they were selling of like a big one and like a mid-size one not too long ago. So I'll be using those later, but this is really good for travel, and like rollerballs and these like little sprays are my favorite when it comes to summertime and when it comes to traveling in general, because number one, I get to keep it in my bag and smell good all damn day. Because I don't know about you guys, but I feel like some scents just don't last on me all day and I just need to reapply. Like, I just want to smell good all day, right? Yeah. So I like to have it in my bag all day, and I also like to have it for travel because it's like convenient, it's small, and I can bring like a ton of them and just layer them all on and smell like a goddess. And that is my YSL Black Opium. You guys should totally check it out. I think it was like on Allure's Favorites 2015 or Top Beauty, whatever, Allure something. If you look on Sephora, they have like Allure, like a little Allure thing next to some of the stuff, and that's how you know it was just the shit last year. So, yeah. So the next thing that I'm going to get into are my favorite songs. I didn't do this last month, so I was like, ugh, crying inside because I totally forgot to do it. So I'm not forgetting this month. Okay, so let's get started with the music. First song that I have been obsessing with is called Love by Tory Lanez. So the next song is called Ballerina, and it's by Belly. You call her a stripper, that's my ballerina. Oh God. See, that's your stage, but it's my arena. She mine. That's not a stripper, that's my ballerina. Oh God. Let me see. Sex With Me by Rihanna. I am obsessed with this freaking song, guys. I'm making love, I'm making nasty. Rip up your dress to make me happy. Sex for me is amazing, but her it'll feel alright. Sex doesn't get any better, make it long, let it be alright. I know, I make it hard to let go. Tonight I'm out of my role. Even if I'm alone. Amazing. The next one is Why You Always Hatin' by YG.
Talking about I'm real in front of your kids, bro. They straight, you shouldn't care at all.
Please, please tell me why you always think.
Why you look?
Please tell me why you always think. Please, please tell me why you always think.
Why you look?
And the next song, if you guys follow me on Snapchat, which you totally should, it's Olivia-Perez, is Three Strikes by Terror Jr. This was the song in the Kylie Gloss video. Obsessed. Party Animal by Charlie Black. Light It Up by Major Lazer featuring Nyla and Fuse. I think this is like the remix version of it. One that I will play is Hasta Que Se Seque El Malecón, and it is by Jacob Forever. Why, but that song just reminds me of like vacation slash like Miami slash like a beautiful tropical island with bay, and I'm just like chilling totally. All right guys, so that ends my favorites. I didn't have that much stuff, I don't feel like, but I did have a ton of songs, and I always like to share that stuff with you guys. Don't forget to let me know what some of your favorites were from the month of June, because as always I love to try new products out. Of course, we all know this. So yeah, if you do like the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and also don't forget to subscribe. That would mean the world to me to add some more people to my fam. I would love to have you guys. There's plenty of room, don't worry. All right guys, I think that's it. I love you so much, and thank you again so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys, see ya.